is a cock is my daughter, and I am called Temperance. We live here together in the old Roman villa. Now is our evening lesson, hunched in the candle-flushed rubble of this once opulent atrium, whittled down the poplar shafts where necessary, bending flat, rub each smooth upon that flap of fresh shark skin. Touch your newly wetted scram sacks to the thinnest end and cut the knots in. Next, with beeswax we glue on the fletchings of a hooper swan. Make them fast with sinew rope from left by a horse, the bones of our innocent dead. We'll fashion arrowheads. She asks why we spend precious time crafting our sheaves by hand, when we could acquire basil albino. Oh, one of the abundant caskets of parting cloud, which every sundown float to ground on the dark balloons. I answer her as best I may, that in a world such as today's, where each person can display a bounty of data on the quivering cave wall of their eyeball at the merest flick of eyelash. The only facts of any worth are not so easily dispersed. Yes, it matters how we learn. Real knowledge must be earned. Everything else is a horse, wisdom, simulacrum. navigates the craggy boulder-strewn terrain. My best ever daughter is fast-flowing water. A funny thing occurs. It's the first time a child of mine has grown past the age of 10, making me the younger one. Rocks go sliding into air, hands of cloud ruffle our hair as we climb the bluff towards the entrance of the beast's lair. Near the top, we hunker down in the glitching rime of a thistle bush to wait for a nap. Seconds, minutes, hours drip away down the darkened porchway. Azure dissolves to pink, and just as we begin to think about